Anime openings are important. They're that one consistent factor that brings us into the series each and every week, and most importantly, credit the amazing people who work on the show. So, in the spirit of YouTube, where top opening videos have become the new cool thing, here is my top 5 opening credits. Gakkokurashi is a fantastic, charming slice-of-life show following a group of girls in high school where nothing goes wrong. This opening features light-hearted music, fun visuals, and simplistic anime... Oh shit, this is the wrong script. Give me a second. Okay, there it is. So now let's take a look at these credits. They employ an orange boulder font over a white background. A common misconception that I've seen online is that this is actually a stroke, and whilst it is indeed wrapped around the letters, it always makes sure that each character fits upon one background and there are no gaps separating it. As well as this, there's a staggering animation that creates a great impression and a general aesthetic that blends together brilliantly. Now this is certainly a controversial pick, and I can see you commenting away right now. Huh? What's Ushio Totora doing above Gakkokurashi when Gakkokurashi clearly has more detail put into the actual animation and colour scheme? Yes, Gakkokurashi's typesetting does have its audience, but I've actually been doing some research into this topic, and I've discovered that behind the important bit here, there's actually moving images that attempt to convey some sort of theme, and I was amazed to find that Ushio and Tora's background moving images actually fit in incredibly well with the font choice. Using a vertical typeface as found in traditional Japanese texts, it employs a calligraphy font, and this is even applied to English words. What amazes me is that this aesthetic is consistent with both MAPPA and Studio Volume refusing to place their logos within the sequence, instead having their brands written in the same style as the rest of the credits. It's that passion for typography that really does impress me, and that's why it deserves its place on this list. The Fate Kaleid series has had a history of fairly basic opening credits with soft colours and shades, but this season they've definitely stepped up their game in all regards. With alternating shades of pink being used for the glow stroke and font colour, it's a bright aesthetic, and there's subtle shading going on there that really makes it pop. Yes, Fate Kaleid surpasses the main series in so many ways, and Ufotable will really need to pick up their game in the upcoming film, Heaven's Feel. In terms of typography, of course. Adding to this design is this amazing blurred sparkle effect that really does draw attention and brings the whole design to life. It's a monumental leap for the Fate Kaleid series and could be exactly what is needed for people to finally accept that Fate Stay Night is shit in comparison. Talking about typography, of course. Fate Kaleid's still better though. It's the final two and the competition is tough. There's no place for mistakes and the crown must go to those that advance the art of opening credits. Gangster falls short of this, but not by much at all. The greatest opening credits are something that moves you, something that gives you passion and a desire for more. Yes, typography is truly one of the greatest art forms, and Gangster shows this incredibly. Starting out with a monochromatic scheme, it shows off some real innovation as more colours are brought into play and the background images change to fit the colour of our splash marks. And with the overlaying glitch effect and gritty non-uniform font, it's an exemplary entry into these rankings. But there's one opening that just about beats it. What if there was an opening credits out there where each and every credit had its own original animation? What if it was possible to put together so many principles of colour, theme and style into one single opening sequence? Viewers, Welcome to Gatchaman Crow's Insight, the best opening credits this season. Showing exemplary use of rhythm, our first credit is Tatsunoko Productions, which bursts onto the scene in intervals, never remaining there for over half a second until it reaches the climax, where it bursts apart into these beautiful, clean diagonal slices, setting the theme for the rest of our sequence. So is that the animation then? Is that what we're going to be seeing the whole way through? Not so, with the next credit assembling and dissembling itself in a brand new horizontal fashion. It's a completely different animation than what we saw originally. But surely it's just a fluke. It can't be. No, wait! This one's completely different, taking a vertical approach, but without the fallout. Yes, this is originality, and it sparks me with the spirit of typography. It's stylish, it's cool, it's the best this season. The best typography, that is. Thanks for watching the Canipa Effect, and I'm really happy that you've come along. I didn't know you were all so enthusiastic about credit typography. Yeah.